Fashion lovers, in today's video we'll be learning about a category of sleeves which is actually attached to the bodies, right? Like maguire sleeve, kimono, dolman and the batwing, right? These four sleeves we'll be learning in this video. So for that you have to suppose this is a fold line, right? And this is again a fold line. This is a fold and this is a fold. If you would mark to name this line AB and CD or AB and AC, these are the lines. Have you understood how I have done this? I have done this in such a way so that suppose this is the fabric, right? You have to fold this fabric at once and then again like this. So this is on fold like this. Here it is on fold and here it is on fold. So you have to fold this like that only. So these two folds we have to create. Now what I have to do, first I am making the maguire sleeve. For that I have to trace front and back portion of the sleeve. For back I am just tracing the neckline because we don't require the armhole and other things, right? And for front I am tracing the entire pattern. See how I am keeping this so that its center line should touch to the this fold line and its shoulder, neck and shoulder point should touch to the upper one fold line. Front I'll be tracing with this. This is the common area, you can say, because armhole is different, so we don't need armhole in this pattern. Right? So we have traced the bodice block. Now what I'll do, we have to drop a perpendicular from this point. Let's say this is a point D. I have to drop a perpendicular from this point to the fold line and to make the point D dash. Fine. In all four sleeves, this pattern would be the same. Tracing the pattern on fold, double fold line, and then dropping the D dash. Now I have to take the length of the sleeve. Let's say this is 3 inches or 3.5 inches or 4 inches, more, not more than of that. I'm just making it 3.5 inches. This is point E. Then D dash to E is equal to 3 to 4 inches, right? Here I am marking a point F. Here I am marking a point F, and from F I am drawing a perpendicular of 1/2 inch and marking a point F dash. F to F dash is equal to 1/2 inch or 1 inch, max to the 1 inch. Now join this, join this and join this. So this is the pattern of maguire sleeve. Now how you have to cut on fold? First you have to cut the back. Don't have to cut this line because this is on fold. Cut this, cut this, cut this and cut this. That's it, right? Then open it and then cut the front neckline. Got it? Right. So this is the Maguire's leaf. Now we'll go with the next leaf, that is the kimono. For kimono sleeve, again I have to take the fold line in the same manner. This is the fold line and this is the fold line. Let's say this is A, the intersection point. This is B, an imaginary point, no length. And this is C, an imaginary point, no length. Now again we have to trace the bodice block in the same manner. Here I am tracing the front block. So let me clear this in the previous leaf. This is the grain. This is the fold. And again this is on fold. Two folds are there. Right. So now let us trace the front pattern. And now the neckline of back, only the neckline, not more than of that, because we don't require anything else. This. Now do the same thing. This is the pattern. This is the point D. Drop a perpendicular D dash. And now what we have to do, because this is a full sleeve, so we have to take a full sleeve length from D to E. We have to extend this point D on the fold line as like this. This is point E. Here D dash to E is equal to 11 inches, that means full sleeve length. Right? This is full sleeve length. Now, what we'll do from point E, we'll drop a perpendicular to create point E dash as E to E dash is equal to 4 to 4.5 inches, or maximum to the 5 inches, because this is the width of the wristband. Now we'll draw a point F here at the side of the corner and take a point of 1 or 1.5 inches down from there. F dash. F to F dash is equal to 1 inch to 1.5 inch. And now we'll join these two with a smooth curve. So this is the kimono. This is the pattern of kimono sleeve. Cut against. Cut these and these as per the rule, and cut this. This and this, the bodies, the outer lines, not this line, You don't have to cut this line. Because this is unfold, this is unfold, and this is the grain. Got it? In the dolman sleeve, again we have to repeat the process. If you have any doubt in the design ideas of the sleeve or the looks of the sleeve, so I would suggest you to please go through the video in playlist 15 days of basic design ideas, and it's day 2 or day 3 video. I have day 2 video, the types of sleeves. There you will get all these sleeves and their design ideas, so that you'll come to know about the sleeves. Otherwise it has been cleared here also. So again we have to do the same thing. I have to draw the basic pattern, the basic block of back, and the front. So fashion lovers, I am getting some requests from you for different patterns and drafts. Like mostly I'm getting a request to explain the process of darted bodies of adults. That I'll explain, because if I'll explain it in between, so it will break the rhythm of the topic. So that I'll explain it after completion of colors, right? Or I'll try to make it after the completion of the sleeves. A, B and C I have marked at random. This is point D as usual. This is point D dash. 11 inches is E. At 11 inches, I am marking E, right? E dash again would be the same, just like the kimono. Four to 5 inches. This is point F. But now in this case, this will not be point F. This will be point F, the waistline corner. And from here, I have to take a width of 1.5 inches, that is F dash. Everything is same, but we have to change the point F. Otherwise, in kimono, it was here. In dolman, it is here. Distance would be the same. And now we have to join . Have you got the distance difference between the kimono and dolman? Kimono has a less wider this pouch than of compared to the dolman. Dolman is having the more wider pouch of this. In kimono, it was this. Kimono, it was this. And in dolman, this is having the difference. Like, it comes from waist. And in the same manner, the fold and the grain. Got it? So now let's see the next sleeve, that is the bat wing. Bat wing sleeve is actually a dolman sleeve, but is having a little bit different it has a different hair only. So in that way, you will be joining this. In bat wing sleeve, all the process is same. You will be joining this to this with a straight line. We will be joining this to this with a straight line waist, right? And then we will divide this line into 3 to 4 equal parts as what I like. It's up to me only. I have divided it into 3 equal parts, and then like this. This is the bat wing sleeve. Now, have you got the difference? Kimono, dolman, and bat wing, that starts from waist only. All the things are same, just like the dolman. You have to take the point F and join it to E dash with a straight line. Divide the line into 3 or 4 equal parts as what you like, and then give the shape of the bat wing to this. This is the bat wing sleeve. Fold line, grain line, everything is same otherwise. So these 4 sleeves we have learned today, that is Maguire, kimono, dolman, batwing, right? In the next video, we'll be learning 3 more interesting sleeves, that is bishop, cowl, and melon sleeve. These are the variations of puff at some stages, but these are different to cut. This will be cutting through different method, that is the slashing method. And till then, bye bye, and thank you for watching this video, friends. Thank you very much.